My name is Elke Thiele. I come from Berlin and I'm an expert on public relations and I started Saving Avenues. You still hear me? Yeah. I started Saving Avenues 12 years ago when I worked for the Federal Ministry of Environment in Germany. They started a whole campaign to save the avenues. I'm here on behalf of the Deutsche Alleenstraße, which is the German avenues road. And I'm supposed to speak on the benefits for landscape and business. I have to admit I skipped the benefits for landscape a bit, since we all know that avenues, tree-lined roads are just beautiful and really good for the environment. The German avenues road started to come to life shortly after the wall came down, when all the West Germans came to East Germany and discovered how many beautiful roads with beautiful old trees were still there, which they had cut down in Western Germany in the 60s and 70s because of all the traffics. And in 1990, they started to a real protest, to write letters, to call just in order to save the beautiful East German avenues. And many people wrote to the ADAC, which is the biggest German automobile association and a real strong, has real strong political influence in Germany, and complained about the road constructions and plans to cut down the avenues. In 91, there was the first registration of East German avenues, just to see what's really there, what do we have. And the ADAC got in contact with the Schutzgemeinschaft Deutscher Wald, which is an association for nature protection, and as a potential partner and a tree expert. In 92, they started a small campaign, Save the Avenues, and they had an avenue alarm telephone. And the idea to establish avenue road in Germany started to arise. And I don't know if you have that here in the Czech Republic, but in Germany we have more than 150 so-called holiday roads with certain topics like a road on pottery and a white stork and fairy tales and some architecture. And they wanted to have the same for avenues. And it was supposed to start in the northeast from Rügen, Isola Rugia, down to the Bodensee in the southwest. And that's what they really did. And in 92, in September, they started to form that working group, German Avenues Road. And they had quite some challenges to cope with. First, they had to register all the avenues in the different parts. And of course, they needed the help of the local authorities just to figure out where could we have that route, and where do we have the most beautiful avenues, the most beautiful trees still left? And of course, they had to take specific criteria such as trafficability and road safety into account. And of course, they also had to guarantee the signposting, which you see here on the picture. That was one of the older ones. And that's what one criteria to have a holiday road in Germany. And in 1993, the first part of the avenues road was opened in May. It was between Sellin on Rügen and Rheinsberg. It's in the north of Berlin, state of Brandenburg. And that's probably the part where the most beautiful old trees still are. And between 93 and 2000, they opened three other parts of the avenues road and went down to quite to the south, to the Bodensee already, and also western Germany. Between 2007 and 2009, they planned to have two more parts through North Rhine-Westphalia. And this is quite a funny story, because the working group of the German avenues road didn't want to add those two more parts, but the state of North Rhine-Westphalia was really consistent, and I said, well, we want to be part of the German avenue road as well. So They did everything and supported the working group. So finally they gave up and included those two more parts. And North Rhine-Westphalia is one of the few Western states who really do something to save the avenues, to support it, and avenues are protected by law in that state. The key data today, the length is approximately 2,900 kilometers. It connects 10 different federal states throughout all Germany. And you have hundreds of sites and UNESCO places and monuments, whatever, on both sides of the route. And you also have, of course, many, many beautiful avenues, new planted avenues, but there are still parts where you just see the sign on the road. You just see German Avenue Road, but no single tree. So a lot of replacement plantings still need to be done. The difficulties are, I think, what I figured out today, much the same like here in Czech Republic or what I know from Poland. I think the same everywhere. So it's increasing pressure on the trees because of the increasing traffic. And especially in Germany, I don't know if you have the same problem here, trees are suffering a lot from the de-icing salt. Because in Germany, the authorities and many people think, well, winter is just maybe a bit white, but only in the nature, not on the road. So they think they could go as fast as they can do in the summer. And of course, the high costs for replanting and also to preserve the existing avenues is really difficult. It's really difficult and really expensive in Germany. Also, a big topic at the moment is the so-called RPS. It's a kind of an official advice by the Federal Ministry of Traffic, and it came out in 2009 and says that if you plant new trees alongside the road, you need to keep a distance to the edge of the carriageway of 7.50 meters. On both sides, which is impossible to plant a single tree there because no community has the land, no one can buy the land, no farmer will sell the land. It's just the end of the tree beside the road. But we started to set up a big fight, and we get more and more people and associations and even members of the parliament to support the fight against that advice. Another problem is, of course, the financing to buy the land and to take care of the existing avenues. And also we still have and will always have the ongoing discussion on traffic safety, especially done by the security companies, who have to pay much more if people drive too fast and are drunk and just crash against the tree. But so far, we can say it has been quite a success. Last but not least, because of the strong partners, which are part of the German Avenue Road. First, ADAC and Schutzgemeinschaft Deutscher Wald. And ADAC is, I think, in Europe, even in Europe, the biggest automobile association. And they really have a political influence. But it's not that easy, since even within the ADAC, there are many people against avenues and some people pro-avenues, so they have a fight within the association itself, but still we can go outside and say, well, the ADAC supports us, and it's one of the partners. And then we have many partners from nature protection, from German tourism and regional tourism agencies. Even the German National Tourist Board supports us with marketing or support of the Federal Ministry of Environment with contacts and information. And it's a good and, I think, quite perfect concept of an ideal holiday road. Oh, you have the combination of nature protection and with the traveling and adventure. You connect many different places, cities, and monuments and sites. And so what we say, der Weg ist das Ziel, so the journey is the reward of all. And you also have a sustainable approach. You connect nature protection with tourism. In 2012, the route was awarded as a selected landmark by the German-wide campaign Germany Land of Ideas. So we are really proud of that as well. Just to keep or to stay in the public mind, we do regular actions and events, such regular press releases, and we did tours with selected journalists, you know, from traveling tourism journalists, and we do a lot of interviews, TV coverage, did it, just showing the different parts, marketing workshops, and of course, public discussions, conferences as well. Finally, we've set up a cooperation with the university in Eberswalde, so some students checked or analyzed parts of the German Avenue Road from different points of view. So we have even the scientific approach and analysis for that. And of course, we do public plantings at the moment twice a year. So not as we can't plant as many trees as we want to, not because we couldn't finance the trees, but it's always difficult to find the land, so we still have to fight all the time for that. But I think the same here. On the ADAC always hands out popular maps to its members, and even there the road is shown on those normal road maps. And we're working on GPS track system on Ferienstraßeninfo, but this is not finished yet. And also we have a new website with general information on avenues, but of course specific information on every single part of the road. And a couple of years ago we added all the events. We have a whole database on events alongside the route, so everyone could check, okay, I want to go from A to B and what's going on there. So, and what is to see. We have a fan page on Facebook, but it's not where I personally would like to have it yet. We're still working on that. But it's getting better. And we have the description of all routes as a PDF, as a download. And only last year we had 40,000 downloads. That's by far the most we've had yet, and we are really proud on that. So people can take it down from the internet, get information on every part, and have a map there as well. So far, the German Avenue Road is by far the longest holiday road in Germany, and one of the best known, I can say. It's under the top five, so everyone knows it. Whenever I tell people, okay, I protect avenues, I said, oh, you're working for Deutsche Alleenstraße. I said, yeah, not only, but that's what they know about avenues. So I can say it's one of the best known projects of avenue protection in Germany. It's really well known all over. And we've had really good press coverage during the last years, and so I can say also the multipliers, the journalists, they know who we are, what it is, and this is a really great success. And also the communities, they got more and more aware of the green treasures they have in their on their land, and some of them begin to take better care of them and to be really proud of it as well. And also local tourism experts started to discover the potential they have there and started to use also the advantage. And if you see that picture there and you're wondering what this old bike is doing there, in the summer a biker called the office and said, well, I'm planning to go on my old bike. It's an old-timers one thing. And I would like to do a small report on the German Avenue route, at least on a part of it. And so we made a deal and said, okay, just write a report and send us some pictures and we're going to buy you a good camera. So the deal was made, and we had that really personal report of a biker. I think he's about 60 years old. And really personal, describing all the sites and really funny. And we had that on Facebook, we have that on the website, and we started to use that as a press material for all the papers on motorbikes and everything and on the website. So it was really successful and really great. And other point of view, it was really funny. Okay. And one of my favorite parts of the German Avenue route is, again, in North Rhine-Westphalia, because that's one thing which I just can call a best practice example. When they started to prepare the two latest new parts of the route in North Rhine-Westphalia, some of the people from the Avenue route went to North Rhine-Westphalia. They went to every single district and talked to the authorities and asked, well, what can we do and where would be the best route? And of course they went to the district Lippe as well, which are now part of the German Avenue road. And they got so attached to that idea of avenues, of tree-lined roads, that in 2010 the whole district started to register every single tree alongside the road and all avenues in the district. And then they said, well, we have discovered, we have so many really beautiful avenues, so what are we going to do with that? Besides the official part of the German avenue route. So they decided to highlight the most beautiful and important ones and set them up together as Lippische Alleenstraße. So they, beside the big avenue road, they have a small one now just for the district and use it as a marketing instrument and as a tourism instrument to attract people there. And the district Lippe is also home of the Fürstenallee. This is about 2.5 kilometers long, close to 300 years old, beautiful avenue, mostly oaks, and four rows. So it's a double avenue, one of the oldest one. And this is one of the pictures here. You see, those trees are never, ever 300 years old. That's true. But that's, how I see it, one of the best examples how you could save an avenue or a place where an avenue exists, can exist, because the authorities of that district didn't decide, okay, we have to cut it down because we can't guarantee the safety and traffic safety, whatever, so the trees are just old and sick, so we have to cut them. No, that's not what they did. They called everybody who could have an interest. They invited traffic experts, they invited all association of nature protection, they invited tourism experts, they invited all inhabitants who were interested and set up a quite long and quite difficult discussion. And it took them a while, and of course tree experts came and examined, analyzed all the trees, and all those people together, I mean everyone who could have had an interest, they decided together, okay, what are we going to do with that beautiful avenue? And finally, it was a tough decision, they decided, okay, they're going to renew it, they have to, because most of the trees are just dead. And they decided we want to have exactly an avenue like we had for our children or the children of our children. So they left just a couple of old trees. So the process is not finished yet. They're still working on it. But they left some old trees at the ends of the old avenue. And in between, they planted a new old oaks. It will take a while until the first alley is going to be as beautiful as it was. But I think in this case was the right decision. Okay. And altogether, you can say the German Avenue Road, it offers a unique nature experience at all seasons. You see that when you go down there, and all the people from the association always try to drive along as many parts as possible. And it connects the adventures of the route itself, and you can really experience some adventures there with the sites in the neighborhood. And it offers for the visitor extraordinary insights of Germany because it connects small villages, nice pubs, and you have always surprises on the road and with big cities as well. And you are invited to make new experiences, of course. Okay. I thank you. And, well, if you have questions on that.
We have this idea of creating a European avenue route, which would connect with the Deutsche Allianzstrasse and extend those routes into neighboring countries. I know it's still a long way to go, but we also hope that such transboundary planting, transboundary avenues that I talked before, could be also linkages and could help to promote conservation, protection of roadside trees in our countries. Mm-hmm.